Good morning to all of us and to the jury. I feel comfort here to stand in front of senior professors who are for the cause of the students and the education system. Today I would like to speak 2 points. Before that, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Trigo Mila. I'm also a part of the ZYPMS working group constituted by the Tata Institute of Social Science, by the director of office before the protests coming up in the campus. So in the context of my involvement, I want to speak 2 points. One is the process of privatization and then the impact on the students. The process of privatization in TS has been started in before 2012. Actually, in 2012, in the 12 plans document, TS has submitted to the government that they have raised 200 crores from private entities and TAS and others, apart from the government fund that they got it. In 2013, the self-studies of the institute has declared that they are going further and raising the funds, 750 crores to be raised from private entities and TAS and corporate sectors. And the expansion of the, as my friends has said, the expansion of the campus has been started since 2004. The full campus started in 2013. 2012, Guwahati and Hyderabad campuses started. That was the time, actually, TS was saying that we are in crisis of finance support from the government. Actually, in 2013, they issued to the SCSGOBC students that they have to pay the upfront fee because we are running out of money. So TS doesn't have more money to support the sections of the community, therefore. But during that period of time, ironically, that this is extending and expanding the course and campuses, new campuses has been established. So this is the process, the kind of process that we can see. Under this, in 2017 October, this has issued an office saying to the ZYPMS students, SCSDOPC. SCSDOPC to pay their full fees. So the ZYPMS working group went to the director of office and saying that we cannot do this, so therefore we have to think of another way. So we have a public meeting, the director suggests us to take a law. So the ZYPMS working was told not to take a law, and then ZYPMS working group to work with the government and other stakeholders, to bring in the scholarship areas which is in the hands of the government. So we have been meeting with the Social Justice Minister, the HRD. Now, I will come to the one point that I would like to highlight here. In this process, the institute is saying that since the introduction of direct benefit transfer, the issue is no longer in our hands. And on the one hand, the government is saying that this scholarship, we have dispersed the amount, and the amount has been located, and the budget has been estimated, and then it has been dispersed to the states. Therefore, we no longer have any state in this. So, the institute on the other hand was of the hand, and the government on the other hand was of the hand. So, in the process of privatization, as you know, this is a laboratory and the gathering of, implementing this privatization. Now, where is the SCSDOPC children to be going? We have been running around the government, we have been knocking the door of the HRD, we have been knocking the door of the Social Justice Minister, we have been the door of the Tribal Affairs Minister. And now we will be having another meeting tomorrow with the Tribal Affairs Minister. So in this context, the government has been washing off their head and the institute is washing off their head. Now the students are helpless. Where do we go? Under this privatization, the students doesn't have any future. And I'm very sad. When I'm standing here, I'm happy because I could deliver this testimony, but I'm very sad I'm the one who is delivering this testimony of the future scholar and the future student. And this is going to be the future of our country and our academic. I'm very sad in that sense. Thank you very much.